So much with the great chef Roy Choi, but first and foremost, his firm endorsement of California cooking.
There it is.
He pointed.
That's the show.
That's the show.
We should be interviewed.
No, that's the show.
Yeah.
But here's the thing. Cook like recognizes like. She's
yes,
the real
that's
deal.
Right, real, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Game you recognizes said you like, game. You watch your show.
I do. I watch both your shows. And I watch this show. That's all
sweet,
I got.
Roy.
There we go. He's got a show. We're going to talk about that. Did you ever think for a second, I mean, this phrase food culture or the fact that, you know, trucks or pop-ups, you tell me, last 10 years, it's blown up.
Yeah, man. They even put the word celebrity in front of it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know where that all came from, man. We're going through the back door usually, you know. I don't know. I think people love food. Finally, there was a moment where, especially with social media and the internet and everything, we're able to share these things. And
what's unusual is you're sharing everything except, you tell me, the thing that would matter most, which is the taste.
Yeah. That's the tough thing. We a lot of my friends and I compare it to like old sneaker culture where you search things out and you're able to, you can only experience it by actually going to the store and getting it. Cooking is the last thing left. Almost everything in our life we can share online, except for cooking.
Yeah.
You know, we're doing the best we can with all the pictures, but.
Well, speaking of pictures, new show, Taste Made and KCET have partnered with you. It's called Broken Bread. What's it about?
It's about our broken systems around food. It's a very serious show, but we've done it in a very artistic, hopefully fun way. But to look at these broken systems that surround us, whether it's homelessness, addiction, lack of food, lack of access, infiltration of processed food through our inner city communities. And we look at all of that and people on the ground. Instead of lecturing you or being depressing, we look at it through people and hope on the ground, people changing these.
I
found it. I've seen it. And it's
Yeah, you came to the premiere.
It's inspiring.
Thank you. That was the goal of the show.
You meet some of these people who are really doing things to help our community through food.
And it's hard to talk about the elephants in the room, you know. And anytime we do, it becomes either a debate or it becomes depressing. We wanted it to be inspiring because all we can do in 30 minutes is try to spark some sort of change.
Yeah.
And that's what we tried to do.
I bet people don't know statistics in this country, how many kids go without
kids.
A meal.
I mean, I learned so much filming the show.
Yeah.
We throw away 40% of the food that we produce. The amount of gallons of water it takes to just make one burger patty, I think it's like 300 gallons of water.
Wow.
If you think of everything that it takes to make one burger patty, from the slaughter to washing down to raising the corn to raising the animal, and it's looking at sustainability, waste, is there a future in a plant-based diet? We look at all of these really serious topics.
Let's take a look at the clip. Here it is. It's called Broken Bread. Watch.
There's some amazing people out there that see the power of food in the same way I do. At the edge of downtown LA, there's a bakery called Homeboy. It goes against pretty much any business plan someone would write. Take formerly incarcerated men and women from rival gangs and give them jobs in an industry where they have no training or skill. But year after year, Homeboy continues to grow. And after three decades, it keeps getting stronger.
Father Boyle and what he has done there. We will tell you this, that Broken Bread premieres May 15th, on KCET. Really good to see you all.
Thanks.
Thanks so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.